Peyton. Starring Dorothy Malone as Constance McKenzie. Werner Anderson as Matthew Swain. Ed Nelson as Michael Rossi. And Mia Farrow as Allison McKenzie.
In Peyton Place, the Peyton Mill represents wealth and power. And over the years, Leslie Harrington has learned to take that wealth and power for granted. Perhaps too much for granted.
I think you're bluffing.
I assure you, this is no bluff. The information I have confirms every detail of Mrs. Harrington's charges against you.
And where did this information come from?
An unimpeachable source.
Which, of course, the same professional ethics that made you ask consent from my attorney to visit me won't permit you to reveal.
Not at all. It's Elizabeth Carson.
Elizabeth Carson's dead.
And she left a diary.
I see. And where has this cryptic document been hiding for the past 18 years?
I have no idea, but that's hardly relevant. The important thing is that the diary exists, and I have access to it.
Access to it? This all sounds very vague, Wainwright. Have you actually seen this diary?
I've seen it, I've read it, and I can produce it in court.
If it actually exists, it must be a forgery.
Hardly. It relates the specific details of your relationship with Elizabeth Carson in her own handwriting.
How can you be sure it's her handwriting?
I've been assured that that can be proved without any doubt.
Assured by whom?
By the person who brought the diary to me, a man who was, well, shall we say, very close to the deceased author?
Paul Hanley.
No.
Elliot Carson.
Mr. Harrington, I have very little time for guessing games.
But why wouldn't he have used it at his trial?
I'm sure he would have had it been in his possession then. Oh, the last entry in the diary. I think that would interest you particularly. It was written on the day of the murder. In it, Elizabeth Carson states very specifically that she expected you that night, that she believed you were going to break off your relationship with her, and that she had no intention of allowing you to do so. Drop the codicilfied, Harrington. You really have no other choice.
You'll have my answer within 24 hours.
Every time I come to town, the boys keep kicking my dog around. It makes no difference. He is a hound. They gotta quit kicking my dog around.
Norman, I won't be home this evening. The community society dinner.
Yeah.
I'm not looking forward to it, frankly. These things can be pretty dull. If I weren't an officer of the organization, I wouldn't even go. But as it is...
You have to keep up appearances.
What are you going to do tonight?
Oh, I'll just hang around here, I guess.
Why don't you get yourself a date? Go out and have some fun.
Fun? Can't you see? I'm having fun.
Look, Norman, if you keep moping around the house the way you have lately, you're going to make yourself sick.
You mean like my mother was sick?
Why is it that we can't have a two-minute conversation without you bringing up your mother?
I guess that's part of my sickness. I love my mother.
Norman. Here's $10. Please go out tonight. Do something. Anything. You need a change.
Is that all you can spare? Money. Just money. Does a good job of tearing down card houses, doesn't it? International Airport.
Norman?
Hi, bud.
Oh. Hey, listen, what are you doing tonight, Norm?
Oh, I just lost an airplane. I was about ready to organize a searching party.
Huh?
Forget it. What's up?
Well, Ellen's got this friend visiting from Boston. A real good looker, you know.
So, naturally, being your best friend, I decided to call you first. Norm?
Yeah.
Well, how about it?
Why not?
Great. We'll meet you at 8, okay? At the shoreline.
Great.
Now, don't say I never did you any favors.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Madam?
Oh, thank you. I'd rather have an artichoke, though, if you don't mind.
Oh, now she tells me.
Too bad we're not in Sweden.
Why, the Swedish big on after-ski artichokes?
No, no, in Sweden they drink glögg.
What's glögg?
No, glögg. It's a wine and spices, and then they stick in a red-hot poker to make it warm. Mm. Or is it mulled ale with the red-hot poker?
Well, they both sound sort of gluggish to me.
You mean gloggish. I don't know why I'm in such a silly mood.
Well, I have that effect on women. It's the sheer force of my terrific personality.
Now you're doing it.
What?
Being silly. It's been a wonderful day. For me, anyway.
Why do you say it like that?
Well, I haven't been skiing in such a long time. I really belong back on the bunny slopes. Hope I didn't ruin everything for you.
Oh, no, of course not.
That's good.
You know, you still have moments of being Alison in Wonderland. I thought the sun. You don't like my saying that? In your
eyes. No. It's not last summer anymore, Rodney. We're different. We're changed. Both of us are.
Well, then let's unchange.
We can't. That would be pretending.
Are you pretending to have a good time?
No.
Well, then I don't understand.
We're two different people.
You know, in another moment, you're going to have me believing that I'm on a blind date with a girl I've never met before.
That would almost be true.
Well, at least we've been properly introduced. To the dark.
Your heartbeat close to mine, and our love would last till the end.
Hello, everyone. think she wanted to show.
What happened to Ellen's friend?
I'm sorry, Norm. I didn't know Buddy was going to call you, and I'd already fixed her up with Tommy.
Come on. Pull up a chair and sit down, huh?
Oh, Norm.
She's always off. Goes like this.
Okay, so it goes like that.
Now what's the matter?
There's nothing happening.
So make something happen.
That's Norman Harrington.
So?
I thought his old man fired your father.
Yeah. Well, what do you want me to do about it?
Maybe thank him for it.
What are you staring at him for?
I wasn't staring.
All you had to do was hear he was Moneybag, son. You don't even know him.
I do so. I was in his high school class before I dropped out.
Well, isn't that sweet?
Shut up.
You want to bet he doesn't even remember you? If you went over and spoke to him, he'd look right through you.
Don't be so sure.
Go ahead, try it.
All right. I will. Hi, Norm. Remember me?
Sure, Rita Jax. What have you been doing?
Oh, nothing special. I've been working in the dime store since September.
Do you like it?
It's okay. And someone sort of dared me to come over and talk to you. You don't mind?
No, why should I?
Oh, have you heard number 14? It's new.
Go ahead and pick him. Go ahead. I'm not really up on this.
Do you still spend all your time reading?
Some of it.
You know, that's what I remember most about you. You like books. And Allison Mackenzie.
What about Allison?
Well, I always figured you had a thing for her. I bet you never even noticed me.
I remembered your name, didn't I?
Yeah. Look at your chick. I guess you figured she wouldn't go through with it, huh?
I don't mind.
How come?
Because it gives me a good excuse to get him over to our table.
What do you want to do that?
Well, like you said, I want to thank him for having such a great dad.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you introduce us? I'm Kitch Brunner.
My date? Norman Harrington.
Nice knowing you.
How are you?
Say, why don't you come over and sit at our table?
Oh, he's here with friends.
Oh, I'm sure they won't mind. Why don't you ask him, Rita?
How about it, Norm? We'd love to have you.
Sure.
Bessie, care to join me for a drink?
Well, no,
I thoroughly enjoyed your hospitality the other night. Why don't you let me return it? Unless you're meeting someone.
No, actually, I'm staying here at the inn now.
Yes, I heard that Carson took back the beach house. Strange that he'd want to live there, isn't it? I'll have another brandy. How about you, Doctor?
Well, I have the same, please.
You're from New York originally, aren't you?
That's right.
Well, I imagine your Saturday nights were much livelier there than they have been in Peyton Place. I know mine were when I lived in Paris.
I'm sure they must have been.
Well, I might be mistaken in your case.
Why do you say that?
Well, I've gathered that up until recently, you've been enjoying a certain social acquaintance with the lovely Mrs. Mackenzie.
Hanley, you seem to be going around looking for trouble. Now, do you want it from me, or do you care where it comes from?
Well, Doctor, perhaps I've stepped out of line, and if that's the case, you'll just have to accept my apologies.
Well,
my, what a wholesome sight this is. Two students in search of a snowstorm.
Hello, Mr. Hanley.
Hi. Dr. Ross. You know, I don't know if it's the brandy or the warmth of your greeting, but I feel well fortified to meet the challenge of the outdoors. Good night. Good night.
Well, I wish I could invite you kids over to join me at the bar.
Oh, that's all right, Doctor. We were just looking for my brother. Have you seen him?
No, I haven't. Why?
We just thought we might all have a sandwich together.
Well, if he isn't here, he isn't here. Would you care to join us?
Well, yes, as a matter of fact, I would.
Don't pretend. You're up to something.
What?
You know what I'm talking about. Norm's drink, what did you put in it?
You're seeing things.
What's gotten into him?
How do I know?
Ducky, awfully funny.
Yeah.
Look, Norm, why don't you come back to the table, huh?
Oh, man, don't be a square. Get the rest of the gang and come join us.
You know they're not about to do that.
Oh, well.
Forget it, okay?
Norm.
Forget it.
Hey,
Norm, don't.
What?
I don't think that's your glass.
Sure it is.
No, but I...
Turn off, will you? Rita, relax. I'm having a ball. Hey, Bud. I got a great idea. You won't come to us, so we'll go to you.
Oh, look, Norm, we...
How about it? All in favor?
Oh, we're just getting ready to leave.
Now, why do you want to do that?
Well, we're going, Norm, and we figured you ought to come with us.
Yeah, Norm. Why don't you go with him?
No. Tell you what. Let's all make it over to my house. How's that sound?
Hey, great.
Sure.
Great. Yeah.
And I'll give a party.
Go with your friends, Norm. Let them take you home.
Aren't you my friend?
No.
Because I really thought you liked me, Rita. You know? I really like you. I mean it. Hey, don't let her bug you, Norm. You got the rest of us. We're all with you. Come on, let's go to that party.
No. Just get out of here, will you? Go ahead. Get out.
Hey, Norman, Norm. You're gonna be sorry.
No, I won't.
The night isn't over yet, baby.
Constance.
Anything wrong?
Wrong.
Allison? Rodney?
No, no. May I come in?
Oh, yes, I was afraid Allison had had an accident. You knew they went skiing.
Yes, yes, I knew.
Oh, of course you would. Come on in.
Thank you. Very pleasant room, Constance.
Thank you.
But then you always displayed good taste. I suppose it reflects good breeding. You know, I remember your mother very well. Remarkable lady. May I take off my coat?
Please do.
She took quite an interest in the underprivileged children of Peyton Place.
May I hang that up?
No, I won't be staying long. I'll just put it here, thank you.
Somehow I'd never thought of you as underprivileged, Leslie.
My father was a mill hand. He died when I was 10.
I'd forgotten. May I get you anything? Coffee?
No, no, thanks. We had a banquet at the club. A stuffy affair. But I'm stuffed. Fine-looking man. Constance, we have a problem. Yes, we have quite a problem.
Allison and Rodney, huh?
Well, it does concern Allison. Or it could.
Stop trying to be dramatic, Leslie.
I'm fighting for my entire future, Constance. You know about the codicil Catherine added to the will?
Yes, I'd heard.
She suspected me of being involved with Elizabeth Carson. Did you know that?
No.
She wrote a letter to her father using that as an explanation for cutting me off from her shares in the mill. By itself, the letter wouldn't stand up, but there's something else now. A diary. Elizabeth Carson's diary. You're going to say you don't see how any of this concerns you.
Yes, I don't see.
The last thing Elizabeth wrote in her diary was that she was expecting to see me.
Oh. Well, Elliot Carson always claimed...
He claimed he heard someone run out of the beach house. He may have been telling the truth. Constance, I want you to believe this. I didn't kill Elizabeth Carson. I did not kill Elizabeth Carson, but Elliot Carson believes I did, and he has the diary, and he's threatening to expose me. At the least, at the very least, it means I'd have no chance of having the codicil revoked. At the most, well, I wouldn't be convicted by any jury. But...
But what do you want?
You went to New York. Elliot Carson followed you there.
He did not follow me.
Elizabeth knew he'd fallen in love with you. She told me so. The rest is simple arithmetic. Constance, you're the only person who can keep Elliot Carson from using that diary.
I can't.
You can't? Allison's mother.
You wouldn't.
I wouldn't want to, Constance. Allison's a fine girl, a lovely girl. The kind of girl I would have wanted for my son. You can stop all this, Constance. Talk to Elliot. Make him realize what's at stake. For everyone.
Tomorrow on Peyton Place, Norman Harrington encounters difficulties after dark. Now stay tuned as Mitzi Gaynor stars in the musical Bloodhounds of Broadway on the USA Movie, next.